In this video, I'm going to give you a quick overview on Google's new analytics tool, Firebase Analytics, which is made with mobile apps in mind. We'll take a look at a sample implementation and I'll walk you through the new interface. All and more coming up right after this. Hi there, and welcome to another video of measureschool.com, where we teach you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and on this channel, we do tutorials, how-to videos, and take a look at the newest marketing tech, just like this video. So if you haven't yet, consider subscribing. Now, a little while back, Google introduced Firebase as its new toolset for mobile app developers to build, grow, and monetize their mobile apps. A bit hidden was the announcement of Firebase Analytics, which integrates very well into these new tools and services that Firebase provides. And it really caters to this new mobile-centric world. The only confusing part of this whole introduction was that Google already has a standing analytics suite with Google Analytics, which also works with mobile apps. Adding to all of this, Google Tag Manager got a new form of implementation, which piggybacks actually on the Firebase SDK. But let's take a closer look at how we can integrate Firebase and use it to measure our mobile apps. All right, today our journey starts at firebase.google.com, the official home of the Firebase suite, and we'll take a look what Firebase exactly is. There's a great overview here, because Firebase is actually a suite of different tools that will help mobile app developers to develop, grow, and earn more money with their mobile apps. So all these different tools are available to the developer to use in their mobile apps. And at the heart of Firebase is the analytics suite. So as you can imagine, all these different tools can be used and also tracked with the analytics component of Firebase. They integrate very well. So if you, for example, use the authentication feature or the test lab feature of Firebase, you'll be able to later measure that data in Firebase Analytics as well. So let's get started on installing Firebase on a test app. Let's go over here to get started. We'll go over to our console, which is the Firebase console. Here you see all your projects. And for a new project, we'll simply create one, give this a name. And then choose our preferred method of installing it. We can install Firebase on iOS devices, Android devices, and also web apps, although the analytics suite is not available on the normal web app calls. I don't know if it's gonna be available at some point, but anyways, we have Google Analytics available for measuring web apps correctly. Now, in our case, I have built a little Android app here. So let's install this on an Android device. We need to have our package name, which we usually can find throughout our application when you installed it. Give it a nickname. And optionally, you can add your SHA-1 key. This is only necessary if you want to use the authentication features of Firebase. Now this will generate a JSON file for you. This is the Google Services file, which needs to be installed in your app folder of your app. I have already done this. And as you can see, it is then available in my Android Studio. And this is the configuration file for Firebase Analytics, which we need to include into our app as well. Now there are certain steps we need to follow. First of all, we will need to add a dependency to our build gradle within our Android Studio. So I've already done this, but just to show you, here's the build gradle file, and I've added the Google services here. And this also needs to be done within the app folder under the build gradle, where you need to add the plugin to reference the Google services. Additionally to this, you will need to add the dependency of Firebase. So in a dependency here, I've added the dependency of the Firebase core file. Once this is added, you need to sync your Gradle files, then Firebase ready to use in your app. Now, how can we start measuring data with Firebase Analytics? There are a few more steps to go through, which are all described pretty well in the documentation of Firebase. So after we have installed the Firebase SDK, we need to add the Firebase core files, which we have already done. But then we need to initiate Firebase Analytics. We need to give it a private variable and then initialize it with an instance of this Firebase Analytics in our main activity. So let's go over to our Android Studio and click into the main activity of our app. And I've already given Firebase here a private variable that we need to initiate, which I've done on this line as well. Now, if I start my app and I don't get any errors, this will already be sending data over to our Firebase Analytics suite. Now, it's a little bit hard to see what's going on under the hood, but you can enable verbose logging for your Android console so you know when events get sent over or errors occur. For that, you need to execute some commands described in the documentation as well. And then you can see in your Android monitor here what data has been logged. So for example here, Firebase is initialized successfully and starting to measure data. And automatically, we are already collecting when the app is first opened. If there are different users, you would have a count of all the users who are using your app and activity connected to that, such as first open or how many times it has been opened in a time frame. This is all sent over to Firebase Analytics automatically. And we should be already able to see the data in Firebase Analytics. Unfortunately, it takes quite a while to populate the data in our console. This is due to the nature of how mobile apps work and how data gets sent over to Firebase. So you need to stay patient. It can take a few hours to be populated. Fortunately, I've already built a demo account here where we can see how many active users are using this app and their activity. Now, what if you wanted to log any other data, custom data that is important for your app that goes beyond the open event, for example? Well, there are certain calls that you can use to log events within Firebase Analytics. They are all described again in the documentation here. What you need to do is open up a new bundle, fill this bundle with your parameters, and then send over a log event call to Firebase Analytics. Now, Firebase already has some predefined events that you can use. These predefined events are special for e-commerce and different kind of apps, but you can also use your custom setup and send in events by yourself. To demonstrate that, I have built in here a click listener for our buttons on our main activity. And again, I'm opening up here a new bundle and then sending in the parameters for the button ID. I have different cases here. Which button gets clicked is transferred into that button ID field. And then in the end, I'm sending over a log event to Firebase Analytics, which holds the button name. We can see again what is happening in our monitor here. When we click a button, we see a event get sent over to Firebase Analytics. That should again transfer into the app. This takes a while. In our demo app here, I have some events logged. You can see the count, and from here, you can also define it as a conversion, which will later help you analyze the data within Firebase Analytics. Now, what would these reports look like if they're filled? Well, Google actually gives us a Firebase demo project that you can also get access to, which holds data for a real life app called Flooded. Let's go into the analytics here and have a look at the data. We see it's quite different from Google Analytics, but we can still choose our date range here and get some useful reports about the activity of the user, the revenue, if you send in any revenue data, automatic data that is collected also by pulling in data from the Google Play services, such as where did your user come from when he installed your app, retention cohorts, how your user is engaged with your app, and if you send in custom data such as revenue and purchase information, you will also be able to get this report filled. And of course, some data about the technology that is running, which app version is running, the devices, and data such as the location and demographics of the user. Now, additionally, you can set up filters. You can define audiences. If you send in events, you have certain attribution that you can also filter down on in terms of networks. That would be if you want to install, for example, conversion tracking for AdWords. You can build funnels and look at a visualization, define cohorts, and if your users have different properties that you have sent in, you can also manage them from here. So there you have a quick overview on how to install Firebase Analytics and how it can be used to measure your apps. So there you have it. This is how you can install Firebase on your mobile app. At this stage, I would recommend to use Firebase Analytics for new mobile apps if you want to track them, although it doesn't have quite all the features that we are used to from a Google Analytics. That said, it's apparent that Google heavily invests into Firebase and wants it to be a success. So I'm not really quite sure about the standing of Google Analytics for mobile apps at this point in time. Are you interested in learning more about Firebase? Then check out this great Firebase channel by the folks at Google that is mainly catered to developers, but still has some very cool information about how Firebase works and how you can track things with Firebase Analytics. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet, consider subscribing because we'll bring you new videos every Wednesday. My name is Julian. Till next time.